And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for a commercial break. People who encourage a relationship between my mom and me see me better. Others, they say I should reach out to my father. Well, I have. Those that know, they say that I should do the military, you know, something like my brother. And those that don't know my family, they say it's enough homeless people out here and I should be another. They advocate homeless shelters over having nothing to eat and sleeping on park benches. Honestly, I'd like to see them choke down that garbage and tolerate those foul stenches. I'm a product of the foster care system, so I don't expect 3 hots in a bed. And I'm educated, so I refuse to allow these adult daycare centers to reprioritize my head. The way that I live is just as I was taught it. So either someone I love did give, or I went out and bought it. Now, not to come down on the rest of them, but you see, for me, I would accept nothing less. So not having an abundance to eat and not being able to play with the heat, it won't evoke stress. But you'll talk down to me in that pretty voice about false hopes because you don't condone this. Like I want to be homeless. People see me confused, amazed, they want to laugh. It's not that they mock me that hurts. You see, I've accepted this as the family that I have. I can ask if they can help me out. Some will, most won't. I could make it simple and ask if they care. Some do, most don't. So of course it's the ones that do, the ones that will, that I try to find. To help someone in my state, I have to patiently await someone in the proper state of mind. So people see me. They move to go around me or go the complete opposite way, and even that's okay. You see, I don't require one positive interaction to occur today. Now, if you believe that, then you're not one of the people who will kindly give. Not one of the people who will go inside themselves and show me that there is a reason to live. Oh, you're spiritual. Well, you see, a Christian will readily share. Not this ass-backwards street ministry that I'm polite enough to bear. Not to be rude, but you see, if I put my faith in that, then Jesus will have come and gone back, and I'll still be waiting to let. Something about the way Nana raised me. How can you convict me without knowing my sins, my demons, or what burdens I fight? But still, you'll talk down to me because, well, of course, you don't condone this. Like I ran to the ballot box and after Obama, I chose to be homeless.
Mm. Wow.
People are hilarious, and the responses that I receive are various. And sometimes I am the one that's downtrodden and beaten. All I can do is watch his giving is so precarious. Women, they clutch me, purse is tight, swear up and down that they don't get to win. Happy brother, happy daddy, happy sons, but it's okay. Dudes, either he's struggling just like I am, a homeless man, or is he a jerk? Either way, I just can't win. Race is not an issue. See, yes and no are universal. Si habla español. And social status, well, shit, let's look at Trump. If the rich are only getting richer, there never will be a role reversal. Question. If I'm but one blessing from success, and you're but one mistake from defeat, can you please tell me how you're high enough above me to look down upon me? Mm-hmm. Nan said, be careful who you step on when you're on your way up. Am I weak? Am I emotional? Am I humble? Am I developing memories? Yep. Am I truly in need? Let's talk about this, because see, I don't talk to this air I breathe. I was born to be a part of the community, and that's my purpose, or so I'd love to be. And, well, right now, I'm in the perfect position to receive. So, don't talk down to me, even if at 5'6", I stand just a tad bit shorter. You know what? God bless you.
Thank you.